Number one, dua, supplicating Allah Azza wa Jal. Sa'd radiallahu anhu, and this is reported by Imam al-Hakim and classified as authentic by al-Albani, said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, should I not tell you of something when a man suffers distress or anguish, can do, and he will be relieved? The dua of the noon, Yunus alayhi salatu wassalam, when he was swallowed by the whale. La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Meaning, by the virtue of saying this and supplicating whatever you want after that, that will be answered and your heart will be relieved from anguish and depression. Number two, dhikr, mentioning Allah, remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. Asma bint Umays radiallahu anha narrated, as reported by Abu Dawood and classified as authentic by Al-Albani, may Allah have mercy on them all, said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, or taught her, rather than told her, taught her few words. He said, if you say them while you are distressed or depressed, you will be relieved. He said, say, Allah, Allahu Rabbi, la ushriku bihi shay'a. Again, Allah, Allahu Rabbi, la ushriku bihi shay'a. And there are many narrations which stated different types of dhikr that relieve one from depression and anguish, but due to the nature of a khutbah, I can't list them all. Number three, salah, prayer. Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu narrated, and this is reported by Abu Dawood, classified as Hassan by Al-Albani, said that whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was grieved, he would hasten to pray. He would rush and pray. When you stand before Allah Azza wa Jal, your heart is attached. Your mind is free of everything, or at least it's supposed to be. But focusing on this act of worship, you're addressing the one in whose hands is the control of everything. So anything that depresses you or worries you will be taken care of when you address it. Number four, uttering salah on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a lot. In the narration, it's a long narration by Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, and reported by Ahmad in his Musnad, classified as sound by Al-Albani, Hassan. He was asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how much of his supplication should be just uttering salah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Until at the end of the narration, he, Ubay that is, said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then I will make all my supplication just simply saying salah upon you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon hearing that, said to him, then Allah will relieve you from all things that depress you and will forgive your sins. Number five in this category, physical deeds, is asking Allah's forgiveness, uttering istighfar. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Imam Ahmad reported in his Musnad, and it is classified as authentic by Ahmed Shakir rahmatullahi alayhi, or rather Hassan by Ahmed Shakir rahmatullahi alayhi, that Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever frequently asks forgiveness from Allah azza wa jal will obtain three prizes from Allah azza wa jal. Number one, جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا من داوم على الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا. Allah azza wa jal will make a way out from him from every hardship he faces. ومن كل هم فرجا, and that will relieve him from all types of anguish and depression. ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب, and will provide from him from means which he never expected. These were some physical deeds one can do in order to relieve himself from depression and anguish.